Welcome, everybody, to a new episode, our first episode of Lunattix. And I'm going to be your host. My name is Luis Lacau from Man Bites Media. Our subject matter expert that is going to choose every single week the subject that we are going to actually be talking about is Naomi fucking Chusid. Without the fucking, but just Naomi Chusid. But, you know, I wanted to emphasize it.
What a glorious intro.
Yeah.
Seriously,
yeah.
What is that?
We had the same thing. I'm like, that's a love an intro.
Great minds.
And the fat one himself from Man Bites Media, William fucking Phoenix. Or Gimli.
Hi. Good to see you guys.
Or the man that could dance to two dance-offs for Halloween Horror Nights and win. That's right,
right.
Boys.
Or one for the fat guys.
Yeah.
And I didn't have to do the truffle shuffle either.
That and Fat Thor dance, too. Amazing time.
I like Hammond. I really like Hammond a lot.
Pretty soon, if you look at my beard, I'm not going to have to do the whiteness.
Seriously.
I just going to wait a few months and I'll have that covered. It is. I love doing Hammond, but it's such a pain in the ass because I've got really dark hair for obviously the ones that can't see me. So it's like a spray paint up top and I got to let it dry and then I got to do the beard. Let that dry, and then like it's basically like two coats. But what sucks is that like when you do it all day, and I'm already going bald as it is, it kills a lot of hair. So,
well, not only that, by the end of the day, the white has fallen off a little bit, and it just looks like a bad dandruff day. So,
yeah, I mean, like, I've learned to like fix that with like because when I first did it, that was my issue. But then there's this wonderful thing called like a sealer, which I didn't know was a thing. So now, like, it literally, like, stays there. And I'm like, thank God for that. But it's such a pain in the ass to get out as well.
So hopefully you don't use Gorilla Glue. Please don't tell me you use Gorilla Glue.
Seriously, what is that? Did you see that she is planning a lawsuit now?
Dude, that bitch is stupid.
She's already gotten, like, a $15,000 settlement.
But dude,
that bitch is stupid.
They put a disclaimer out there.
Stupid.
They're like, "We're so sorry to hear about this, but yo, dumbass, did you not read the back?"
And people still came to her defense. People still came to her defense because they were like, "Well, hair is not skin." You sit down. Sit down and shut up.
People are idiots. Let's be honest.
I can't deal with that. That drove me crazy when
I saw that. I was like, "What the fuck?" Are you serious?
Seriously, if you are stupid enough,
and she's like. I'm like, dude, that shit makes me laugh already when women start tapping their hair to like stop itching and shit like that. And I'm like, she's tapping at it and it sounds like a board of wood. I'm like, holy shit.
God.
Some people are just better off being swallowed than conceived. That's a whole different story.
Dude, seriously.
End up on a wall somewhere.
Yes.
Like, what's that, mommy? Your brother. Go to your room.
It just reminds me of that scene in Beavis and Butthead Do America where Beavis is trying to input himself into the egg.
Oh, yeah. The first time he got laid, he's like, hey, baby.
Fucking love that scene. So, all right. Naomi, what is the topic for today?
Okay. Don't hate on it when you first hear it. I'm just saying, it's top.
Horse movies!
I think we're going to have to instill a one drink minimum prior to the subject just to make it, you know, allow ourselves to flow better.
I think it will. There you go. He needed that before getting on this call. All right.
I know that we're not sponsored, but I decided to try Bang birthday cake. It's actually not bad.
Really? Mm-hmm. What does it taste like?
Like birthday cake?
Literally birthday cake.
Like birthday cake? But birthday cake is a wild, like a wide term. You know, you can have a bunch of flavors of birthday cake. Is it like a vanilla birthday cake?
It's chocolate. You know, it's vanilla-ish. It's like, if you ever go to Cold Stone and gotten their birthday cake at Cold Stone?
Yeah.
It's that in liquid form.
Oh.
So whatever that taste is, now you're drinking it. So, yeah, here's that.
So in other words, just put Cold Stone into a blender and you got that.
Yeah, or just let it melt.
You know, the consistency of a melted ice cream is really gross to me. I love ice cream, but once it melts, I'm like, no. Not so
like
much.
White sticky stuff?
Yeah, poor Lewis.
Where's the cream filling?
Are you a strudel or a Twinkie?
world will never know.
All right, then.
I'll get a few drinks in her and I'll let her tell me.
I'll have a cocktail ready next time.
If I know, I'll make a speech at your wedding and I'll either insert Twinkie or strudel.
Right.
All right. So the topic this week, very topical as it is almost Valentine's Day. I read a glorious article today, and it was the worst gifts a man can get a woman for Valentine's Day. And I love this because you're two dudes, and I don't know. I know Lewis's view on Valentine's Day, and he hates it. Dink, what are your views? Are you pro-Valentine's Day or anti-Valentine's Day?
I don't care Valentine's Day in the sense of if she's into it, then we celebrate it. If she's not, then happy Valentine's Day, I guess. But I mean, and I've been with both ends of the spectrum, and those that didn't, it was, you know, I still got them like flowers and like maybe, or maybe like a card just, you know, for the hell of it. But it was just kind of like, okay, because again, it's one of those, like, I don't think that we should be spending or putting one day aside a year to celebrate love. If you are love each other, you love each other every day. Like, the other day I went and I got Samara flowers and she's like, what's this for? I'm like, because it's Tuesday. Like, there was no reason why. It was, but just,
that's good, because most women be like, what did you do wrong?
Yeah, right.
That's what I would do if he brought home flowers, because it's such a random occurrence. I'd be like, what did you do wrong? What am I going to be angry about? Let's get this out on the table now.
But then I've been also with girls that were like all about it. So I went out and it was kind of like Christmas a little bit, but it was more like you get presents for her on Christmas, like on Valentine's Day, that you couldn't necessarily, or not that you wouldn't necessarily, but have more meaning and like relationship wise than you would for like a birthday or Christmas, or in this case, Hanukkah, whatever the case may be. Don't get her a vacuum. That's for fucking sure.
Perfect segue, as that is number one on the list of what you do not get a woman is a vacuum.
A vacuum. Unless, like, and once I actually went out and got a vacuum, but it's because she needed and wanted a new vacuum. And I knew that she was the kind of person that, like, she wouldn't have been insulted by it. If anything, she was happy about it because she's like, oh my God, I need this so bad. Thank you so much. And
that's,
I'm like,
a certain age.
Yeah.
That really is.
That's when socks become a commodity that you want to have as a present. Once you hit that age, you know you're old.
So can you either of you guess?
I think cookware.
You also know you're in a Valentine's pandemic. I finally found the actual name brand Clorox wipes.
Oh, nice.
And it was like limit two per customer. So I got one for her, one for her mom, and they both loved it. I'm like, you want one of your presents?
That's romance for you.
And they were like, yes. And I'm like, that's Valentine's Day in a pandemic. Clorox, they are beyond the moon. So you should have
put a little heart on the top.
But tell me, what do you think would be like the number two kind of worst thing that you could get?
I think anything for the kitchen. Any type of appliance for the kitchen, any type of cookware, any of that.
Bowling ball.
Bowling ball. Well, she's really into bowling. It could be endearing. According to them, it's Spanx.
It's what?
Spanx. You know those things that make you thin, that like take off 10 or 12 pounds when you put them on?
But, and again, that, I feel like these are like, for the most part, yes. Like 99%, absolutely. But I know that, like, if I got a pair of, like, cute Spanx that I saw for Valentine's Day for Samara, she'd be like, I love these. Thank you so much. Like, she wouldn't be, like, insulted. Now, if it's somebody that's constantly having body, like, self-love and, you know, doesn't feel like that they are good enough or whatever, everything, then I get it. Like, don't go out and get something like weight loss related, because they'd be like, this is also another thing you don't buy on Valentine's Day, because you can make the steak on birthdays, Christmas, you can get away with
diet
it.
Diet food.
No, clothes. If you buy her clothes, you make sure that you know the perfect size.
That's on the list too. It's either lingerie that's too big because you thought she was a fat ass, or lingerie that's too small and you make her feel like a fat ass.
Exactly. So, like, be very careful when you buy stuff like that.
That's why you buy a gift card and you wrap it nice.
No, but that's on the list too, because it seems like an out. Like, okay, I'm not really, go buy yourself something, honey. I mean, it's like that's what a sugar daddy does. But the third one is my favorite, and I'm really interested to hear your guys' thoughts on it. because the third gift that I guess men actually give their significant others is porn for Valentine's Day.
I've had some girlfriends that were heavy into it, but then again,
but did they make porn for you? Was it like a homemade sort of thing, or is it like legit just bought you like, you know, big dick? Well, the thing is, like, I mean,
in
like
this day and age with so many websites that are free, whatnot, like why are people still buying porn movies? Like I understand, right? You know, it's still
for the quality acting, right? The cinematic.
Oh yeah, moments. Absolutely.
Have you ever been to a porn shop? It's like $30-$40 for one fucking movie, dude.
Do I have to answer that? Why do you know that?
Because people go to because
he's a man, and
I know, like,
what
are you doing? You're like hitting up the pornos on the way home. Like, what the hell?
There was a time the going right in his life, Naomi, that you know.
Yeah, he like knows the going rate. He's like, do you know what they charge for a movie now? When I went there yesterday and talked to Big Mo,
now,
I mean,
but,
come on.
You know, they
at least he's not telling you what
movie
the rate is to go like in the adult theaters in the back. Then you can.
Oh God. Oh, that's well, a New York thing, dude. That shit don't exist in the South.
Oh, we don't,
that sounds like a Miami.
You want a bat? Go to Tampa.
Yeah, no. You got glory holes in the South. That's a different story.
What is a
glory
hole?
No.
It's a hole in a wall, and you stick things in it, and you hope for the best.
Things is a euphemism right there. Things in
Tampa,
there.
There's a place called Fantasyland in Tampa that's like, they have a whole-ass movie theater. They have like a whole-ass like private rooms. They have a pool hall. They have like a smoking area outside. Like, look it up. Trust me. It's they don't have that up there because they don't have the money in New York to do stuff like that. Trust me. That's a Southern thing. That's where, like, you can buy 16 acres for, like, $5.
Okay, but since we're on the topic of porn, kind of segueing into that, what are your thoughts on porn once you're in a relationship? Because they're saying this is, like, a gift for the relationship in theory.
That's fine. I mean, you could learn shit.
You can
learn it.
Well, I mean, if you're dumb, I guess. I mean,
if you're a new couple or something like that, you're in like your teens or like 20s.
Oh my gosh, like those teens we saw the other day, it was so awkward looking. Like you could tell that man had never had a woman. You really could. Like
they were holding each other like this awkward like like that.
Okay.
Walking in the mall. It was like
awkward. Yeah. And you could tell homeboy was dressing for this like goth chick that he was with and did not look the part at all. It was pretty bad. So, but I don't know, as a learning tool, what are you going to be like, pause, definitely, let me rewind it? It's not a YouTube video. Come
well,
on.
Well, no, like, I mean, like, I have.
Like if you're watching porn for lessons, you do that on your own, and then you impress your woman with some skills.
No,
like,
but the other thing is, it's also a way, it's a gateway to have them try new things.
Yeah.
Okay, have you ever done that? Have you ever done that to suggest something that you wanted to do and they weren't so into? I know, like, chicks with gray went all, like, freaky for a bit, so.
I had that conversation beforehand, and I was like, hey, there's these, you know, fetishes and stuff that you may not have heard of, especially if she's, like, inexperienced. And instead of, like, trying them because you don't know if she may like them, be like, you can watch them first. And then if you're like, maybe I'm into it, then you can slowly try it. And then that's when the whole, you know,
okay, as a novice to porn, because it really irritates me and it's just so annoying, the little bit that I've seen, what would be a fetish that you would think that in porn would be something that would like entice someone? Because when I've seen it, it's, I don't know, I'm like, oh my God, that's really big and I don't want that in that hole. Like, I mean, I just like, I don't look at it and go like, ooh, that's something I want to try. I'm like, ah, how does that not hurt? That's like a watermelon going in there. It looks really big on camera. Like,
tying up, spanking, handcuffing, blindfolding, like it's what I consider like entry level BDSM, like things that they may have heard but never seen, and it's like, okay, here's a chance to see
basic
it.
Basic
bondage, like, you know, obviously, like, we're not talking like fisting here. That's
but you're also you say basic bondage to people, and they're like, the first thing they think of is Silence of the Fucking Lamb, and it's like, no, we're not going to stick you in a well and feed you little crackers and shit.
No,
you know,
that's level 3 bondage.
But I saw another article when I was looking up stuff about that today, and a guy posted an article this week, and he was talking about how Silence of the Lambs is the most perfect Valentine's Day movie ever. And it was released on Valentine's Day, but he said it is the perfect love story of our time. And he said more people should embrace Silence of the Lambs as their choice to watch on Valentine's Day.
Nope.
Deadpool. It puts the notion on the skin. We're getting into BDSM. You know, we're good. Like,
Deadpool takes it up the butt for International Women's Day. That's pegging. That's right in there. So, you know.
Oh, piff. So the other ones I saw in there, there was like lottery tickets, cash for gifts for people. A scale was on the list, and I think that would be the worst. A scale. Men actually get like a scale.
What?
No. I don't know. Like,
no.
Like, that, no.
That's like that moment on Family Feud. Nope. We're not answering that question.
That may be worse than a vacuum.
Yeah.
Just be like, here's something for you to clean around here because I feel like you don't clean enough. All right. Whatever. But it's like, here's something to weigh yourself because I think you're fat, and or to remind you like how much you really weigh around here. And like, no, to me, I know that the vacuum is the number one thing that is bought that shouldn't be bought. A scale should just be number one, period. Like, that's
I really think it should. Like, a scale is pretty.
That's
pretty
a personal thing that you buy for yourself. That that's one of those, you don't gift that to anybody. Ever.
Well, yeah. It's like a really like souped up scale that they really wanted for a while. Like, I don't know. Like, I wouldn't buy myself one of those fancy scales. My mom bought me one once and I was very offended by it though. Like, she was like, so you can weigh yourself. I'm like, I don't know how to feel about that.
Only time I would buy a scale for somebody, obviously not Valentine's Day related. Like if they just got a new house and they're building their own gym. Like, if one of the spare rooms is a gym, and they're like, I bought us all the equipment and whatnot, and they keep mentioning that, you know, they don't have a scale or whatnot, and like, their birthday's coming around, or Christmas is coming around, be like, here's a scale. Like, you can add that to your gym and have fun, because it's not like, I'm trying to show you you're fat and you need to weigh yourself on this. It's like, this helps you complete your dream gym room.
I feel like that's something you would really have to preface before they open a gift, though. Like, you've got this souped up gym, and this is to complete your fantasy gym having this. Like, I just feel like if you hand it to them, they may not connect the dots, even if they're like super into it.
I would do it like more to like a male friend than a female friend, because like...
Is that weird?
I have female friends that like... They're into gym and whatnot, so it's like, all right, they'd still be okay with it, but I'm still like, don't want to cross that bridge.
Only time you buy a scale or anything like that, that weighing yourself, you buy it with the person, and they go, oh, I like that scale. I want something like that. Okay, you want to get it real quick? That's fine. We'll add it to the cart. That's the only way, only context that it will be okay to buy if you're not buying it yourself.
That's a wisdom of a divorced man right there.
What you want to do before you buy a scale is weigh your options.
Oh, jeez.
I love it.
Oh, God, the dad jokes. For fuck's sake.
Come on, you didn't see that one coming?
So what were the other ones?
Well, so some of them I don't really understand. I think it was more women bought them for men because it's like the women would buy deodorant.
That was the first thing I was going to say.
Mouthwash, things like that. They were like personal hygiene items. And they were like, ladies, men don't like this. If you don't want a vacuum, a man does not want you to get him deodorant for Valentine's Day. That's kind of a cop out, I think.
I also think that it's just like, again, like going back to what I said before, like Valentine's Day is something that you want to get, like that's on a personal level. It's like either you know they're going to enjoy, but it has something, or you can do something together. Like, she can't hear me right now. I just got a Switch for Christmas, right? And one of the games that I got was Just Dance, which I got because I move, helps me lose some weight. And she tried it. She absolutely loved it. So then she sent me a video of other motion sensor video games for the Switch, to which, you know, it was kind of like a gift idea. So like, I went out and I got Mario Tennis because you can move around, play. We're going to play together. It's not like, it's like, oh, you want to lose weight? Here's Mario Tennis. Go lose weight. Have fun.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, no, we're going to do this together. We're going to exercise together. And it's one of those, like, you... Having to go to the gym, especially nowadays in a pandemic, let alone in a pandemic, but beforehand, it's like you got to get dressed, you got to go, you got to sweat and whatnot. In the comfort of your own home, you're dancing to music, You're playing tennis. You're doing other things. You don't even realize how much, like, we turned on Just Dance. Like, it counts how many calories you burnt every dance. And in, like, four dances or five dances, we'd burnt over 100 calories in, like, 20 minutes. And you know what I mean? But then you go to the gym and you see all these workout things and you're like, oh, I got to do this and do that. I don't know. Like, I feel like this is more beneficial than, like, here's the gym membership. Again,
it doesn't feel like work.
Get her a gym membership as a Valentine's Day.
See, you know, I would argue because, like, I took Zumba for a bit because everyone was talking about how fun it was. And, like, in half an hour, you can burn 500 calories. After, like, one song, I kind of rhythmically did the white girl thing in the back where I wasn't actually dancing. I was just kind of rhythmically bobbing. And at the end, they're like, you burned so many calories. I'm like, I think I ate more in the Reese peanut butter cup I had before coming to this class. So... I'm motivated to move, but once I get into it, I'm kind of like sitting is so much more fun. Like I'm a really good sitter. I really am. The moving around and losing weight that way, I lose interest really, really fast. Especially Zumba, because I can't shake my ass that way. Maybe William can give me some lessons on the ass shaking, because like I looked at that woman's ass and I'm like, there are muscles in that ass that I don't even think I've ever exercised in my life. She was a Hispanic woman. And I'm telling you, her jiggle was like the sexy jiggle. And she was leading a bunch of white girls in this class. And it was not the sexy jiggle that was happening because I was in the back. So I got the full on view of all of it. So the other one on the list that I absolutely adore is a jewelry box the size of a ring box, but there's no ring in size. Like the, like, especially if you're in any kind of public place, like a restaurant, that's not something you want to be whipping out during it.
By the way, behind your head, who is, yeah, is that, because I always get it mixed up with the
Mark Tooch. It's the Tooch.
It is the Tooch. Okay. Very nice. It's
glorious.
It is.
One of my favorites.
So between the two of you, like, what's the worst Valentine's Day present that you guys have personally gotten?
A breakup.
And wow. Yeah, nope, that's definitely up there.
Let me tell
you this question.
No, let me tell you this ridiculous story. I went out with a guy for 2 years. It was Valentine's Day, so it was our second Valentine's Day together. It's like after dinner, we're sitting on the couch. Dude gets down on one knee, he's holding my hand, and then he's like, I spent a lot of time this last month thinking about my life and our relationship and the next step, and he's like, and I really don't think I want to be involved with it anymore, so I'm going to break up. And I was like, what the fuck? Like, seriously? Like,
did you cook dinner that night?
Huh?
Who cooked
dinner? Did I cook dinner? No, we went out to dinner. It was an Olive Garden fail. I'm telling you, that was the demise of that. But so I would say a breakup was the worst gift I ever got for Valentine's Day.
Okay. Lewis?
It was food-scented candles.
What?
I mean, yeah. It was like bacon-scented candles. I was like, I looked at it and I was like, what?
This is a deeper meaning, like, because you love ham so much, like, no. You like to fill your house with the smell of pork.
No, there was no inside jokes. This was a person that, a girl that I dated for, like, maybe 2 months before, and she gave me, what do you call it, bacon-scented candle, and I was like...
Was it made out of bacon fat?
No fucking clue.
I don't know, like, that... Maybe I re-gifted like it to somebody. Like, a novelty candle filling your home with the glorious scent of, like, congealed bacon fat. I mean, it congeals like a candle, doesn't it?
I don't know, but that shit smelled disgusting.
I was Did like, you actually light it and then you re-gifted it?
No, I smelled it and I was like...
Because that's tacky. You can't re-gift a used candle. I've gotten one of those before as a gift. It was like it was burned and I'm like, really? Like, you can't hide once you've used the candle. There's no one like I think it was like smooshed back in the middle to make it look like there was no indent from being burned. I'm like, dude. So what was your worst Valentine's Day gift?
I honestly don't know. Because like, here's the thing with me. Like, I'm always appreciative of somebody making the effort. Okay, first of all. So, like, I'm never, like, what the fuck is this? But, I mean, like, I don't think that there's ever really been a present. Maybe I'm one of the lucky ones where, like, I've, like, again, you know, I've never been dumped on Valentine's Day. I've never gotten, like, bacon-scented candles on Valentine's Day.
I think there's a gift in the making for him.
But I mean, because like there have been times where, you know, like especially growing up, we didn't really have a lot of money, you know, me and her. So like they got me what they could get me, whether it was something, you know, a small token or of their appreciation or their affection for me. And they couldn't go out and get me all these extravagant gifts. And I know that there were a few which like felt bad because they're like, I'm sorry, this is all I could get you. And I'm like, don't ever feel bad because you went out and whatever little money that you could put aside, you spent on me. And all you got me is a card because that's all you could afford. I got a card for Valentine's Day. Somebody took the time to go out, get a card, pick the card, write in it, and give it to me. To me, that's a wonderful present. Yeah. So, like, I have to think about it and maybe, like, message you guys and be like, actually, come to think of it. No, this is never really – I've gotten some great Valentine's Day presents, that's for sure. But
yeah, flip side, what's a good Valentine's Day present you've gotten?
A great one that I got was when I was married, and I felt bad because this was like the ultimate, they didn't do it on purpose, but it felt like the ultimate guilt trip. My two, the then stepdaughters, they had gotten into some kind of like big trouble and I had to like put them in a corner and ground them like the whole nine yards. Like I had to go full dad mode. The next day, which was the day, 2 days before Valentine's Day, because they had to give it to me early so I could make plans for it. They came to me and they're like, we want to give you your Valentine's Day present early because we feel bad. And they were genuine. They're, like I said, this was not a guilt trip at all. It was just like they were young too. So like they weren't even teenagers at the time. But they would get an allowance every month. And if they did chores, they would get more money and everything else. They put money together and bought me a ticket to the Daytona 500.
Wow.
Aww, that's so sweet.
And I felt like shit. But in my mind, I was like, no, I had to discipline them. And I'm like, and I was like, oh, thank you so much. I'm fighting back tears because I feel like an asshole at this point, knowing that they had done this for me. And I was like, oh, God damn it. I hate you kids right now, but I love you kids. So yeah, there's that. On Saturday, weather pending, hopefully it doesn't snow on Friday, Samara, because he got canceled for our anniversary because of snow, Samara's taking me to an alpaca farm. So I get to like walk around and pet alpacas. And I've always loved alpacas. I've never going to be able to touch one. I've played with llamas. Goats, pigs, cows, horses. But there's something about alpacas, which I'm like, oh my God.
I feel that's such a specific gift. Like, you really have to know someone before you gift that to them. But that's alpacas. Really cool.
And so watch, before you go to the alpaca farm, watch Color in Space.
Color in Space?
Yes. Uh-oh. It's a Nick Cage movie.
Happen to have a movie in your back pocket to that reference? How the hell is that a thing?
Naomi, welcome to 3 years of us podcasting and him doing this every week. Random movie out of somewhere. He's like, speaking of which, here's a great segue for this random
segue.
There's a great line. He goes, what happened to the alpacas? And because he actually has an alpaca farm and oh my God, it is a glorious movie. And the alpacas.
You have way too much free time. I'm just going to throw that out there. Like, what the hell is that?
It's a great movie, by the way, too.
You know who has alpacas on, like, who has a farm with alpacas? Robert Downey Jr.
Am I missing out on the alpaca trend? I mean, like,
we actually just saw Chaplin.
What is that even? What is this? Is it like a goat? Is it like a camel?
The only reason I know that.
I have no idea.
That's a llama.
There's a big difference. The only reason why I know that, I'm a RDJ fan, but there's an episode with – so David Letterman, after he retired, he now has a Netflix special, and I think it's called like And My Next Guest Is or something like that.
Yeah.
And he's had like, you know, President Obama on there. He's had like all sorts of like, people on there, and I watched the RDJ one. And part of the segment is he went to RDJ's house in California, which is a farm, and the dude's got alpacas and sheep and pigs, and I'm like, I want to go work for RDJ. Like, I'm okay. Be like, who's your boss? Iron Man. What? So, but yeah, no, the alpacas and the llamas are a little bit like the gators and the crocodiles.
It says they're cousins. I'm looking, there's a whole chart. They're cousins.
Hispanic cousins or American cousins? Because there's a difference.
No, I love this. It says a llama is very brave and an alpaca is very gentle and timid and can learn tricks.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I want to see one do a trick.
Alpacas do not spit at you, whereas llamas do.
Perfect segue. If you want to see something about a llama, Emperor's New Groove is a must see.
I thought she was like, you want to talk about somebody spitting? And be like, okay, we're back to porn. Anyway, I'm excited about that because
that is awesome.
Who takes their significant other to go, like, you know, to an animal farm and see, you know, South American animals? Me, because I love that. And
are they kept inside? You said it's snowing up there. I mean,
They're kept in barns, but I mean, alpacas and llamas are also built for cold weather because they originate from like South America, specifically like the Andes.
Yeah.
So they're built. It's like a yak. You know, like a yak is big and is, you know, he's a tank. So coldness is like,
I have to like Google. What's this? Because,
it's like a camel, but for a cold.
What is?
The llamas and alpacas are like camels, but for cold.
Okay, yaks are scary. Yeah. They're like a woolly mammoth.
They look like
they're like a really woolly horse.
Look, this one looks like a cow.
That's a fat.
Like there's videos on YouTube of like alpacas, like when they run, they kind of like hop. So they look like they're hopping and they're so happy. They always look like they're smiling as well.
Yeah.
They don't really run, they hop, and it's like the cutest thing. And I'm like, and we get to go like on an hour long just excursion and we each get our own alpaca. And I'm like, I'm going to TikTok the fuck out of this. I told Samara I wanted to show up like in a poncho and like, you know, the little South American hat. And she was like, wow. I'm like, she's like, that's kind of racist. I'm like, how is that racist? I'm Latino. If anything, it's from my country. I'm like appropriating my own people. And she's like, oh yeah, I forget.
Like, I think that would be glorious. I would so love to see their faces when you walk in with like a cape and a
hat. No. You got to do Pancho Villa and what do you call it? And Don Quixote.
Oh my God.
That would be perfect. It would be perfect.
I guess, but no.
And the poncho works.
Also, Don Quixote is in Spain with horses and mills, not with alpacas.
Yeah, but you can
creative license.
Yeah.
Creative license. Wow. It's like Scarlett Johansson. It's like we're doing Muhammad Ali. She's like, I can do Muhammad, let's go. Be like, no, calm down.
You could go as Hammond and you could be like, welcome to Alpaca Park.
Oh my God. I do have Thor with me though.
Oh, that would be glorious. I'd love to see that.
Walk around and be like, what is this animal? It's great. I want another one. I am wearing my alpaca socks because those are warm as fuck. If we're going to be trekking in snow, my feet need to be warm.
So you're going to be wearing one of their cousins' leather outside skin type of thing.
It's called wool.
Oh yeah, that's right. They're woolly. You know what? All right.
Anyway. No, you know, it's sort of like when you're at Epcot, you know, when you go through that fishy ride, like at the world of the world, and they're like, many of the fine meals at Epcot are made with the fishes in these tanks, and you're like, wow, looking at dinner right here. You know, like
I think we broke William.
No redneck has shown up with a fishing pole trying to catch his own dinner.
Like, it's in Florida. One, you know?
It's in Florida. I promise you there's a story somewhere there.
Oh, yeah.
There's a story somewhere there. I mean, come on. Look at what happened in the last Super Bowl here in Florida. Leave it to Florida to have a streaker in the Super Bowl.
I thought that was glorious. I'm sitting there, I'm like, take it off.
And he did better than most of the linebackers and shit, dude.
But when that dude tackled him, that was glorious. That was like the awesome. Greatest. You want like a slow like recap of that
story? Is like why he did that?
Oh hell yeah! he was fined $1,000, and he's like, well, it's a $25,000 bet. Fuck yeah, I'm gonna do
$25. Yeah, 25. He put down $25K on that there would be a streaker at the Super Bowl, and it was like a plus 375 odds. So he paid his friend to distract him. So his friend went out and he got caught first. And while they were taking care of his friend, he went down. That's how he was able to come down the field. And he ended up making $340,000 on that. And he only had to pay like $1,000 to get out of jail.
That's glorious.
I'm like, I wish that would have been my friend, because I would have put all my money on just that bet and sat back and be like, money.
Yeah, seriously, dude. Oh my god, that was glorious though. But for me, I think best Valentine's Day gift ever, and it's when you said your story, I was like, god damn it, you son of a bitch, you stole my thunder on that one too. My stepdaughter gave me, I think we had been, her mom and I had been together for about 2 years at that point, so we weren't married or anything yet. But she gave me for the first time a picture for Valentine's Day drawn on a piece of cardboard with me part of the family.
Aww.
I still have that to this day in my like memory box thing.
That's really cute.
Yeah. And I love that. That forever is one of my favorite gifts of all time.
I got a ring that had you and me forever inscribed in it. And that was the guy who dumped me on Valentine's Day a year later. Wow. So I scratched out the ring and I changed and I inscribed in it "fuck you" and I sent it back in a little letter for him. I didn't want it anymore, but it was really sweet when I got it. I was like, "Oh, we're forever! Yay!"
Okay, I know this is gonna sound really cheesy, but like, because I miss it now because they're both gone. But like every year, I would get a Valentine's Day card from my grandparents, and even after my grandfather passed away, for a few years after that, my grandmother would still send me Valentine's Day present. I'm talking like 13, 14, 15 years old. But now that they're both gone and I don't get that anymore, it's like one of those like, treasure it while you have it, kids, because it doesn't last forever. And I still like, I have like a little storage unit here. And if I go in it, I have like a stack of their cards and letters and everything they ever sent me, like together. And I will never throw that out because that is irreplaceable. I don't care if everything in my life gets stolen. As long as I have that, I can replace just about everything else.
Yeah. I'm really cold hearted. I have put like a, how long do I have to keep a card before I feel okay throwing it out? And it's about a year. And so I have no cards and I feel bad because some of them, like they're no longer in my life. And I'm like, oh, I should have saved that. But when I get a card, I'm like, all right, how long do I have to keep this before it's okay to throw it out?
So
I'm, you know what? I hate cards where it's just the name signed in it. Nothing else written. I've gotten a bunch like of Valentine's from guys that I was involved with, and they buy like this really pretty card and they like just put their name at the bottom. I'm like, what the fuck is that? Like, I'm looking at you. I'm kidding.
Yeah, I'm like, I didn't do that. I know you hate cards, so I'm like, no, I'm not.
I do. My mom sends me cards all the time, and then she like, or she'll send me like a thank you card, and then she'll send me a thank you for thanking me for something. Like, my mom loves cards. She sends so many that eventually I did just have to throw them out because there were too many cards everywhere. She sends them for everything.
My ex-fiance's grandmother would send us birthday and Christmas cards. And she would write poems in the cards, but she really sucked at them. And also, she was like very religious, so it was always, you know, talking about Jesus and God and Mary and all this stuff. And we'd be like, we would sit there and be like, all right, let's see what it's this time.
I'm like a four-year-old. I still, if I get a card, I kind of secretly, I'm like doing the shake of like, is there something in it? Like something like cash or like a check in there every time? Like,
oh yeah, four-year-old.
I open it carefully so it doesn't fall out. I always go like this. I put it like that and then like the potato.
You gotta want something in there. You can tell by heft though, usually, if there's like a gift card, because usually people go by that. So again, I'm like, oh, okay, well.
But if you get like a $20 bill or a $50 bill, you won't be able to catch the weight on
that. Yeah, but no one gives you cash when you get older. They give you the card and you're supposed to just be like, oh, that's sentimental. It's so nice. Can I chuck that out? I don't know.
They always used to give me cash.
Well, you know, that's because you're a Cuban drug lord and you get cash in your cards. I don't get any cash. I want cash.
She still, every day, every day she's like, so when is the Cuban drug lord coming?
Oh, we're money. Married now. I want the Cuban drug lord money. I'm like, his family all live in huge mansions.
They're still in Miami. They're stuck out there somewhere. They're still waiting to come in.
It's in shoeboxes under the armory.
I want the Cuban drug lord money. That's what I want. I really do.
No, we have it in our pet tigers.
You wanted to be rich, though, Naomi. You should have gone Colombian. That's where the money is.
Cuban money doesn't
roll over well in U.S. dollars, but Colombian drug lord money, that's where it's at.
It's a damn communist.
Whatever.
So what was your favorite Valentine's Day?
I told you it was my ring that I ended up returning in an envelope. Yeah, I will say the first time a guy got me a rose, even though I don't like getting flowers in general, but I was like 16. And, you know, disclosure, I didn't actually date any guys until I was 19 because I was fugly in high school. So, like, he got me a rose, though, out of sympathy because they were selling them in the lobby. And I was like, oh, this is so sad. Nobody got me a Valentine or a rose. He's like, oh, fine. But it was really nice. I kept that rose for forever. I kept that rose for, like, 4 years because I'm like, oh, look, a guy got me a rose finally. I felt so special for a minute, even though I got it under duress.
You said you were fugly in high school. So are you dating Louis to remind yourself of your high school days?
Hey, now.
Hey, listen. All right.
Hey, we haven't recorded in like over a month. I got some catch.
Get him in. He really does. He really does.
Come on, the comparison between me and the Tooch. Come on.
Okay, so okay, I gotta know, William. When was the first time you had like okay, let's say a girlfriend, a serious girlfriend? How old were you?
A serious girlfriend?
We're talking about relationships.
I was in college, so 17.
17. See, did you say you were in college and it was and you were 17?
Yeah, I graduated high school at 16.
How? What the hell kind of?
I skipped my sophomore year.
Like a beautiful mind kind of thing. You were just so brilliant. They skipped you over.
I skipped my sophomore year. Well, I transitioned to public high school from private school or private homeschooling at the end of my freshman year. So they gave me a choice of either skipping my sophomore year or skipping my senior year. And in Connecticut, sophomore year, you have like a whole bunch of like added tests, like state tests that you got to take. And I asked them, I'm like, if I skip sophomore and go straight to junior, do I have to take these tests? And they're like, no. I'm like, I'm going to junior year. So, yeah. So I was 16 my senior year. I turned 17 less than a month before I graduated high school. So I was 17 my first year of college, and I dated like this Polish girl, and I turned 18 dating her, and it was cute because they have this tradition in Poland that when you turn 18, you are gifted like a pair of just like baby shoes.
Which I thought that was going to go a completely different direction.
I really did too. I was like, oh, you're legal now.
Right?
Your virginity is lost.
The statute of limitation is passed. It's fine. And then she went back to Poland for the summer, and I then talked my dad into letting me go as well. So I spent like 3 months in Poland, which was fucking phenomenal. If you get a chance to go visit the country, go. It is gorgeous and so full of history.
Are the Polish jokes real?
Some are, yes. But so is the stereotypical Polish cuisine, which is like amazing. And I learned to cook so much Polish food, and I actually managed to speak Polish for like almost a year and a half because she was off the boat Polish, so she was surrounding herself with like-minded people.
The boat.
And Polish. I learned and picked up a lot of Polish to where when we went to Poland, I was able to have conversations in Polish. I was like, all right. But yeah, so that was like my first serious girlfriend, and it was a lot of fun.
Say something in Polish. Do you still know anything? Like a random word?
Well, I don't know. There's Dzień dobry, which is good day.
Okay, that is like his, like any kind of Hispanic language where you add like 9 letters in to make the sound. I try to Dzień read dobry. Things phonetically, and like he actually says them out loud. I'm like, there are like 9 extra R's in there. Where did those come from?
It's not written at all how you would think. Like they do not write phonetically at all. Yeah. There's Kahamche, which is I love you. Kahamche Tesh is I love you too. Bardzo dobra is very good.
It sounds very, very Russian.
Sounds like German.
Well, yeah. You have to remember they were under Russian, like they're like literally right next door to Russia. So, you know, it's like,
yeah, it has that mixture of Russian and German.
Like her little village literally was sitting on this huge lake, and on the other side of the lake was Russia.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah. Whenever we saw boats getting in the lake from the other side, we were like, oh, fuck, it's happening again. We'd be like, is the Germans coming from the other side? Which way do we go?
Germans?
But what's great.
Have you ever seen that movie? You've seen Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels, right?
It's been a while, but yes.
But one of my favorite lines by far is, what do you call it? Jason Statham is talking to his companion, which is this short Pancho Villa looking motherfucker that he goes, he pulls out this giant like Magnum gun and he goes, what is that for? The Germans?
The Germans.
Okay. And that shit forever stuck in my mind. So whenever somebody says Germans, I'm like, the Germans?
You're special. Yes, you really are.
One thing that I loved about Poland was like, if you go north on the Adriatic, Sea, there's a place called, there's a town called Hell, not with two L's, just one L. And you can't get to the ocean with your car. You got to park. It's a national park. So you park and you literally have to go through these sand dunes. And I'm talking like Sahara level height sand dunes. And when you get to the top, you always see is sand, but then you go maybe like a quarter of a mile through these dunes. And then you reach the sea and you literally just see the water out of nowhere. And it was like glorious. I really wish that like Facebook and Instagram like were a thing back then, because the pictures and the live streaming that I would be able to get in this country was like, it's some things that people are like, holy shit. Like I having grown up in Europe, I feel so blessed that I was able to see so much historical stuff that a lot of people, like I see on Facebook, they're like, they put up the Neuschwanstein castle, which is like the big white castle that sits on top of the mountain. They're like, oh my god, I really wish that, you know, I could go there and see there. And I'm like, I've been there like three times when I lived in Munich. Like, I've been inside that castle. We walked that hike, which, again, you can't drive. You got to walk. So you got to be in shape to go see this fucking thing. But it's, like, absolutely gorgeous. You know, Buckingham Palace, Paris, like, all these beautiful things. And it's, like, I don't know. Like, it's times like that that you stop and you feel blessed as to, like, what everything you've been able to experience and what your parents have been able to give you as, you know, because obviously I was a child. But, and I think that that's why, like, I learned to, like, appreciate, like, the little things, going back to, like, just getting a card for Valentine's Day and just being, like, a lot of people be like, gee, thanks. I'm like, thank you. It's just because I've seen it. Like, I've and I know that you guys have as well, you know, on different levels. I'm not saying I'm, you know, here I am better than you guys. Obviously, I'm not. but it's, I don't know. Anyway, I'm done putting my heart on my sleeve.
So sweet. It's so sweet. But I noticed that he got suspiciously quiet when we were talking about his first relationship and the age there. It's because he's a man slut.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yes, he's suspiciously quiet.
I mean, I was not legal when I lost my virginity. And she
How
was
old were you? Or, wait, was this your losing virginity age two, or was that before?
I lost it at 15.
At 15. Okay, there we go.
Wait, hold on. Let me do the math. No, yeah, no, statute of limitation is definitely passed. 25 years later, she was in her mid-40s.
Holy crap. Wasn't that like you, though?
No. And she was married, obviously. Nice.
A cougar. A slutty cougar at that.
I was cougar bait before cougar get baits were cool.
All right, come on. Quiet one.
I don't remember the age, but 7th grade.
Damn. Well, I mean, he's Latino. You know they start early, and seventh grade is already like a year too late. So you know.
Whatever. I was all innocent.
What about you?
I was 19.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was bad. It was very, very underwhelming. I was like, oh, that's it. All right. That was very underwhelming. I don't know. Everyone makes such a big deal out of it, you know? And I think I just watched, like, American Pie and all that. So it was, like, such a big – everyone, big deal that was going on. And I'm like, oh, all right.
I showed her a movie called Kids. I don't know if you've ever seen it.
Yes.
Yeah.
So believe it or not.
That movie was – she said one line, and I was like, babe, really? they asked, what's the balloon for? And I'm like,
no, I said, why are they breathing in helium? Because I didn't know what the balloon was for. Don't give me that look. Where would I ever know what that was supposed to be? Like,
oh, my sweet summer child.
Yeah, right? And then I was like, she's like, how the fuck do you know that? And I was like, dude, this was legit probably one of the closest movies that I saw that was my group of friends was very similar to those people.
No, okay, it's tragic. And I told this the other night when we were out with friends, is like the first time someone was talking to me about weed or anything like that, they were like, well, it's a bowl. And I'm like a porcelain bowl from the kitchen? Like, I was just like, completely unaware of what the terminology was. I'm seriously, I'm like Googling it on my phone. I'm like, what's a bowl? Is it like a kitchen bowl? Like, what are we talking about?
Yeah. You know, I just think it's an exposure thing. You grew up in a small town.
Yeah.
In Michigan.
I like how you add that to state. In Michigan.
Well, I mean, like, I guess it's like different kinds of small towns.
I grew up in a town of the hash bash. Like, drugs were everywhere. I was just completely unaware. I'm walking around like, hey, what? What's going on? What are all these porcelain bowls you're using? Like, I mean, come on. It's just like, I don't know.
What are all these glass pipes for? Do you use it for tobacco?
Well, I do remember, I remember sitting around with a group of people and they were using like a hookah. And I was sitting there, I was like, that doesn't seem very sanitary. They're like, you are so not in the vibe. Go away. Like, leave, child.
So the other thing was we saw a meth pipe downstairs. And she was like, how do you know it's a meth pipe? I'm like, because it's long, thin, and it has a little bowl at the end. And it's like, really?
Wait, hold up. Oh, time out. Hang on. Hold on. You randomly found a meth pipe?
Downstairs? It was downstairs in an apartment that we're living in.
Okay.
Yeah, our neighbors suck upstairs.
Apparently.
Yeah.
Or they blow, you know. They blow.
I sent you a wonderful picture, by the way, William.
Oh, no. I know your pictures that you send us.
So I grew up a lot into that scene, dude. Like that's all we did was just hang out.
I've seen this before.
Yeah, I mean that's shit that we grew up with in Miami. That was just lifestyle. I don't know. So, anyways, I think that was pretty fun. Please, everybody, I want everybody to actually share some of the stories that you had for Valentine's Day. The good, the bad, all the shit, the weird shit that happened to you. What other weird stories have we gotten over the last few weeks? Do you want to share any?
In terms
any
of what?
Just weird stories in general.
Oh, no, you're putting me on the spot. I always read weird stories.
Okay. Wait. Yeah, exactly. The girl who won't tell us what the topic is complaining about being put on the spot.
I know. I'm like trying to think of the weird stuff that I've read. I can't. I don't know.
I think the chick with the glue definitely takes the cake.
The glue was
that dumb
bad.
Bitch. Oh,
the glue, yeah, the glue girl was just like.
I'm telling you, my favorite story I read in the last few weeks was the guy who, the girl, she was on Tinder and he felt a need to rip on the dress she was wearing and how it was unflattering and how he couldn't live with himself if he didn't let her know how ugly she was in her dress. And like the company that made the dress made her a model on the website. And wow. She was like, tell the guy this, like you're our new model now. I thought that was great. I love it. I've never used Tinder, so I don't know how it works. I'm like, what's swiping? I'm completely out of touch, but I don't know. You said you had like, used Tinder, right?
Swipey?
Yeah, I know that, you know, when I met him, I was like, I know Spanish. I watched Dora the Explorer.
Oh my god. Did you guys see the live action movie?
Yes.
Yes. My daughter, she loves that movie. Well, she did. She made us watch it and then she dipped like halfway through.
And we're like, nope.
He kept watching it for a minute. He's like, all right, maybe I'll finish this because I don't like stopping halfway through. And then he's like, 10 minutes later, he's like, nope, I can't do it.
I was going through Lewis's voodoo library because you can tell when he started dating somebody with kids. You look at like the 400 movies beforehand and they're all just like adult cinema, Marvel movies. It's like, you know, all adult themes and materials. And then all of a sudden it's like Pretty Pink Ponies, Dora the Explorer. This is where he started dating Naomi.
Dude, he is his own worst enemy, though. Like, I'll be sitting there walking the store, and he's like, oh, but look, it's a pink fluffy dress. We can get the kids. I'm like, dude, you buy them too much. He's like, but fluffy. I'm like, seriously, what's happening here?
Wait till the kids are older and he can fit in their clothes.
You know what? She, especially Reese, the youngest one, we got her, Dr. Seuss dress. That has become her favorite dress. It's, what is it?
Oh, the places you'll go.
All the places you'll go. So it has all the balloons. So it's a skirt with all the balloons on lacing type of thing. It is beautiful. And she loves that dress.
So loves. He was afraid that she was going to like wear it out. And we got it at Once Upon a Child. So, you know, it was like a $3 dress or something like that. He's like, I want to get her another one. Sends me a link. It's $27. And I was like, no. And he's like, but she loves it. I'm like, no. What the hell are you doing? What have you become?
Daddy Lewis.
No, Glorious is when I saw him and he was folding up their clothing and he's like, look, baby sock. I'm like, oh my God, what has happened to you? And he's like, but sock.
See, I'd be like, it's a sock. Dobby is free. And like, stop doing laundry and just walk away.
Oh no, I think one of the most glorious moments was when Halloween rolled around and I got the skeleton goat that's an animatronic, and Max, our middle one, is terrified of Halloween shit. So we put this thing that it starts what is it called?
I'm already judging you.
What is it?
The buying that it was like, meh.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that was called, but anyways, we would put it next. Right. I think we put it in his room on the bed a little bit. And as soon as he opened the door, this thing starts with the mouth going like that, shaking, and red eyes. He runs out of there. He goes, you guys are the bad man! You guys.
Of course, I was like, we need to go get the goat back and put it in his bed and just have it waiting for him next time he comes over.
So I've set that up when Halloween was around. Every day we put it in a different place. It was like Elf on a Shelf. Elf on a Shelf.
One day you guys are going to wake up and that head of that goat is going to be in your bed. And you're going to wonder why. This is why. Remember this moment. What goes around comes around. And
seriously, but you know what? Now he's not terrified of Spirit Halloween, which he was. Every time we'll get near Spirit Halloween, he would start crying. At the end of Halloween, he was perfectly fine with Spirit.
He would have forgotten by next year, so you're going to start all over again.
Nah, I don't think so.
No, I think we will. I think so.
Well, then what you do is, since you still have to go, you just start in September, so by the time October rolls around, he can just walk right in.
No, but he didn't tell, you know, he's also got like the 7-foot... like skeleton that he hid in the laundry room that he had to walk by when he came in.
It's not a skeleton. It's a witch. But this thing is 7 feet tall and it's like full life size. And the thing starts going and start
a judging face is all you need to see.
So on top of a college fund, you're putting aside therapist money, right?
And you know what? That's how my dad got me out of being afraid of shit. You know, and it worked.
That's your model?
I thought it was when you got married. The first time, not the second time.
Yeah. Yeah, that's
so
true.
So far, so good on number two.
Minus the trauma to the children, yes. You know. Got a man up. He's like, you got to put hair on his chest. I'm like, he's 4. And he's like, too late already. We need to catch up.
Remember, as far as I know, they're not Latinos. So if they don't have a beard by like 6th grade, it's okay. It'll come.
I think one of the funniest things is seeing, I have my IT guy. He's ironically, he's Korean. And...
Oh no. Where's this guy?
He's trying to grow a beard. Dude, it looks like patches of shit on your face. And I'm like, what's wrong with you? Just put the mask back on. Please put the mask back on. And he goes, you're an asshole, man. I was like, how long have you been growing your beard out? I was like, 2 days. I shaved it out clean. It was like this. And he's like, you dick.
Horrible human being. I'm just going to throw that out.
Yeah, I've had this on for so long that I don't, like, I look at pictures of when I, before I had a full beard, and I'm like, why did I not grow it earlier? Like, it's so, like, if I ever get a job where they're like, you can't have facial hair, I may have to get a different job.
I like mine short. Mine, the max that it will grow would probably be about your size. That's the max it goes. It does not go any further than that, ever.
Like, I trim it, like, every other week. Like, right now I haven't shaved. That's why you can see, like, right, usually this entire patch is not here. And then underneath, like, I shaved, like, down here. And then I just, like, I've been doing my own hair this entire pandemic. But I've also been doing my own hair and facial since I was in my teens. But that was one thing that I loved about the pandemic. Like, in the middle of it, watching people giving themselves haircuts. Oh, my God, that was glorious.
Yeah, seriously.
That was pretty awesome.
No, but yeah, like, I can't grow that long anymore. Like, it makes me itch already. Just, no.
I was never, like, even when I was younger, I had, like, beard and facial hair, but I never used, like, products in it until last year. Samara got me, like, a little bottle of, like, it's called Valhalla, mm-hmm. and it's literally, like, beard, and it makes it so soft, it doesn't itch, it's, like, it's beautiful, and now, between her and another friend of mine, I've gotten a couple of sets of, like, I like the liquid over the wax, like, there's, like, beard wax. I don't like the wax. It just gets way too, like, clumpy in there. But, like, and it smells so good. So, I don't know. But then again, yeah, like, the length that I have right now is, like, as long as it goes. Like, I'll never have, like, a full, like, Thor-looking beard.
No, I can totally see when you're, like, a really old man, like, 80 or 90, having one of those really creepy, long beards.
The Leonard Skinner.
You know, when you look to, like, Dumbledore age, and then you've got it all grown out and ready to go, like, I can totally see it. Just
Which
don't
one?
Be one of those creepy
Dumbledore
ones.
Dumbledore 1 or 2?
Well, just don't be the creepy ones that, like, braid it or, like, put weird crap in it, you know? Like, couldn't you see sitting there with, like, a long comb when people are trying to talk to you and you're, like, combing a really long-ass beard just to fuck with them?
With your corn pipe?
I would love... Yes!
that you could really steer into the skid of Connecticut. You know, really steer into the skid of that.
That would be glorious. Really, yeah, would.
So. Oh, you know,
your new job like that. Yeah.
instant Santa Claus all year round.
Oh my God, yeah. That would be glorious.
When were you able to grow a beard out? Like, how old were you when you got, like, a full-on beard as opposed to that patchy crap that, like, teenage boys have when they're trying to grow one for the first time?
Again, I don't know if it's because of my genetics and my genes being Latino and Hispanic that, like, when I didn't shave, it always, like, as you can see, like, how it is here.
Yeah.
Like, that's how it would come in. Like, it always came in together.
Yeah.
And
mine,
I think,
was never patches.
I started seriously shaving 13, 14, maybe. I was already.
Oh, you're before. Like the Grinch.
Yeah, pretty much. I was
like 8 years old.
I think was either 8th grade or 9th grade, somewhere in that period of time.
I think it's because you're both Hispanic. That's what I think this is.
Well, Brandon, dude.
Brandon is like a man child. I'm sorry.
Brandon's
like
patches. Like, for anybody out there that doesn't know, Brandon's my cousin. He's also one of the hosts for Man Bites Film. 3 Idiots with the Mic, etc.
I'm sorry, Brandon stopped aging at like 12. He just got taller.
When he grew a beard before, it was like a patch. One here, and then one here, and that's it. And that was until he was about 19.
I can totally see that too. Like, do you like my patch of beard right here? It's very manly.
I would give him compliments. I'll be like, oh, your peach fuzz is growing in. Grandma has been a better peach fuzz.
There are older women that have more hair than Brandon was going to grow into the beard.
Italian women especially.
when I first started shaving, like, I could go maybe a week and a half before it looked like this. And I was like, I have to shave. Now, this is like 3 days, 4 days. Like, it just, I wish that my hair on my head would come as fast as
right?
it
seriously. Face. Seriously, same thing. It's like, come on. It's right there. Just grow here, not here. Because, God damn it. Seriously. And then mine, it grows out red, which is weird because my hair is black.
All the white that you see used to come in red. This is why that's gone white and the rest stayed black.
Yeah, if your hair is black, right? There's no red up there.
And I still get, like, if I get close enough, like, right here, it's a different shade than the rest, because that still comes in reddish. But the reason why I have white hair is because after a certain length, like...
You're married?
I think it was around that time where it started coming in red. And then after I got divorced, it started coming in white. And I was like, all right.
That's what I'm saying. But,
marriage will do that to you.
Yeah, marriage and kids.
Wow. I'm going to see if you guys still have that wedding in October. You're like, due to unforeseen events.
I always joked. I was like, I lost the first bit of hair with, what do you call it, with CVS. And then the other half of the hair went when I had a stepdaughter.
And now you got three.
It's already left. Gone. That's it. There's nothing.
Be nothing left.
It's no like hair. That Homer Simpson episode where it's that retrospective of how he lost his hair.
I was going to say, you can say bye to the rest of your hair in the back of your head now.
Well, at least I don't have to shave, you know? I'm good with that now at this point.
You think?
Yeah.
I don't know. I always think it's like the men, they always try to desperately hang on to as much hair as they can before they take the plunge and start shaving it.
Nope.
You know?
Nope. Do no you comb over.
You can see how thin my hair is, but I ain't shaving that shit. Fuck that. It'll
Have you tried like all the hair products?
I've tried all sorts of.
They
dishes.
Never work, right? I've never heard of a man having success.
Well, I think also because I just get like lazy and I forget to take like the pills that I'm supposed to or whatever the fuck. Like I'm just gonna grow out my hair as long as I can at one point and then just have it like plugged in there and just never cut my hair. that's my plan, but we'll see.
I heard a really funny story once. I got a guy, he went to go get one of those, like, I don't know what they put the plugs in your hair. I don't know. It's something where you regrow your natural hair. And they told him, they were like, it's totally anonymous. No one's ever going to know that it was you. Then they used his face on a billboard. And the only thing they put two little black dots over his eyes to give him anonymity for it.
Wow.
Cause the dude was like 23 when he went in there and he looked like he was a super young guy and they were really trying to get that group. And he was like, really? No one's going to recognize me. It was like his shirt. I think you could barely see like his work badge. It was like a very obvious photo. And they were like, well, we took your eyes out. No one can know it's you. And he was like, that thing ran for 7 years. It did not go away.
Sucks to suck.
The only thing I think of is when I hear about plugs and stuff like that in the hair, I think of that episode of Arrested Development. I don't know if you've ever seen it.
Never. I think I've seen like maybe two episodes of it.
So Tobias is this psychologist that is just retarded, for lack of a better word. And he's just out there, man. And what do you call it? He gets these plugs because he's completely bald, right? And they're bleeding the whole time. But not like regular bleeding that it kind of, you know, like it stops. It bleeds. And it's like actual pus bleeding. It's the most disgusting thing in the world.
That's pretty awful. Ugh.
What's funny is that like wherever the light is sitting on you right now, when you went to explain it and had your hand up here, the shadow it created, like when you opened your hand, no, other hand, use the other hand. And then like open up your fingers. Now, Naomi, look at his head. It really looks like he's got a comb over that we were just talking about.
Pretty glorious. Now he can be like, I have hair. Shadow, gotta get in the shadow, right?
Haha, I have grown overnight.
Okay, this is what you get for having those long, luscious locks as a teenager.
Right?
This is karma.
Yeah.
Like, you're gonna lose it all.
I mean, probably. You
know, I blame it on Pantene.
Too.
You blame it on Pantene?
Yeah, Pantene.
But it... Pantene's glorious.
My hair used to be as long as Naomi's when I was in college.
Oh, yeah. Probably not as Jufro-ish, though.
I could literally, like, put it back like in a ponytail. Now,
oh my gosh,
like,
did you rock a man bun though?
I'm gonna God, no. Okay. No.
No man bun.
It was like parted down like the middle kind of thing. But
I had it like that too, and then
I don't know. I'm not into the long dude hair. I told Lewis, I was like, if you'd shown up and you had like shoulder length hair, that might have been the end of that moment. That's like a
dude. My hair was luscious too.
Ever the perfectionist, he decided to go bald ahead of time.
I'm sorry. There's something about the long man hair. It just reminds me of like Shrek 2. You know when he's like long and golden hair. Like, well, I feel like men who have long hair they're very vain. Men who have long hair are very vain.
So, like, are you not, like, one of those girls that, like, lusts after, like, Jason Momoa or, like, the long...
No. I like a neat and attractive haircut. That's why, like, when Max gets his hair too long, I'm like, nope, we need to trim that up. Neat, and no woman is going to ever say that my son is a man bun. I'll cut it off in the middle of the night if he does that. Neat and attractive hair. It's important. I'm like Tim Allen in Home Improvement. Remember Brad grew his hair out in that weird thing, and he's like, military haircut. That's what we got to get.
Hey.
I can't get into it.
I got Mr. Clean coming soon, so.
I know. It's nice and I always tell him, like, even now, I'm like, your hair's getting a little long. Maybe we could shave that now.
Wait, are you getting the earring as well?
I get the puff out.
You should get an earring. You could be Mr.
No, you're saying like Mr. Clean is coming. Are you getting like his ear?
I'll get the gold ear.
That's a cosplay waiting to happen.
Right? It really is.
He's got the white outfit.
What's great is that like, because I never wear it, people don't know, but like my left ear, I got my ear pierced when I was 18 in Poland, actually. And I came home. That was a great thing with my dad where he was like, what is that? I'm like, my ear's pierced. Okay, where'd you get it done? Like some tattoo place in Poland. He was so happy about that. Let's not even mention when I first started getting tattoos and then I got my tongue pierced. But my ear is actually still pierced. Like, I don't wear it, but like if I were to put a earring through it right now, it would go right through and pop right out the back.
I had one for about a year and a half. You still see the spot.
So would either of you ever get a Prince Albert?
Oh, fuck.
Thank you, Robin Williams, for teaching me that term.
No.
Yes, I had to Google it while I was like, I'm just glad he demonstrated what he was referring to because I'm like, what? What's a Prince Albert? So would you? Like,
nope.
No.
Hell.
Nope.
Fuck.
What about the tongue piercing? Can you push, like, do you still have one? Could you push one through?
No, I didn't listen to the warnings and I got a tongue piercing and it was like a metal bar and I ended up cracking a bunch of my teeth and then I got some teeth in the back that got like impacted and then my wisdom teeth, they got it impacted and the wisdom teeth started pushing through them as well. So I was in pain for like a month. So I had to go get dental surgery and I only had the tongue out. Like I only had the thing out for like 3 days because they're like, you can't put this back in for like 3 days. And when I went to put it back in, the hole had closed already. And I was like 20. Let's see, I moved to Florida in 2007, so I was almost 30 at the time. So I'm like, that's it, done. Like, I've had it for a few years. I've had fun, and now my teeth are regretting it. But I didn't feel the need to go and, you know, get it done. I got more tattoos instead.
When I think of a tattoo, what do you call it, a tongue piercing, I think of Rat Race.
Oh, yeah, how his tongue is black.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I fucking love that movie so much.
My God, that was a sleeper hit. That was one that I enjoyed it because at the time that I watched it, the only person I really knew. Wait, is Whoopi? No, Whoopi Goldberg's not in it,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, she's in it.
Yeah, it was Whoopi Goldberg and Mr. Bean. Those were really, really? The only
You didn't get into people. John Lovett?
No, I didn't really get into like even now, there's movies that I will watch now. That I'm like, oh, holy shit. Like, I know who this person is. Like, back then, growing up in Europe, I knew who Stallone was. I knew who Schwarzenegger was. Like, the really big hitters. But, like, coming back, like, oh, like, Tim Curry was another one. That, like, to me, Tim Curry was, like, the bad guy in Home Alone 2. And then I started watching all other stuff. And I'm like, oh, all right. He's done a shit ton more shit. Yeah, so I, for example, I found out the other day that the woman that plays the mother in Juno, in the movie Juno is the press secretary in West Wing.
Yeah.
And I was like, holy shit, it's CJ. So, yeah.
I fucking love West Wing. That is such a great show.
I don't like being brought aware of characters that I didn't realize they were something else and something that I hated. That happened to me recently watching Love Actually. And he's like, you know, that's Rick Grimes. And I'm like, you fucking son of a bitch.
Well, the guy
that see that because dude, I hate Rick Grimes so much, and I used to love him in that.
She legit stopped the movie and goes, what the fuck?
It's like glass breaking. I'm like, what?
Why do you not like Rick Grimes?
Let me count the ways. Rick Grimes.
Oh, he's a whiny bitch in Walking Dead. Oh my God.
The first episode, I was really hoping the whole time that he would die and he wasn't a long-standing character. And I didn't watch Walking Dead until like 6 seasons in, and I had went into it with no frame of reference. So I didn't realize he was a long character. I'm sitting there the whole time during the first episode. I'm like, oh my God, I hope this loser dies. And he just kept living. And then someone told me that he dies later on. And I was like, oh, I want to watch that just to see him die. It's like Star Trek Next Generation when Tasha Yar dies. I like, I will rewind and watch
Rick
that over
Grimes
and
over. Doesn't die in Walking
Dead. Does he die? I thought he character was written off.
No, he is escorted off in a helicopter, and we don't know what happened to him.
Oh, God. I thought he died. Now he's really
actually talked that, A, they're making a movie with him that's Walking Dead based, and B, because they're wrapping up Walking Dead, he may make, like, a cameo at some point in the final season because they go looking for him or something. But yeah,
sad. I thought he died. Now you've ruined my whole night. Thank you.
I was happy when Carl died. I was like, yes! Thank God. Him and the Chinese dude. I was like, yes!
That fucker died. And his poor eye.
I hate it. Bro, I paused that. I was the only asshole in the group of, it was a bunch of people watching it in a bar. And I just go, holy shit, that is awesome. And everybody looked at me with this face of like hatred, tears swelling in their eyes. And I'm like,
I felt really bad for the other guy. No one ever cared that the other, I don't even remember his name, the ginger guy.
I fucking love
was like,
him,
suck
dude.
My nuts or whatever when he dies. Like, no one gave a shit. All the press was about Glenn dying. And he's like, the actor's like, I died too. No one cares, but whatever. Like,
because he went out with balls, literally.
He did. And like there was so much like, because I started watching videos about that episode, and like when he knows that he's about to die, apparently him and one of the other characters, I think it was one of the black girls, had a connection, and every time he would say goodbye, he would like, you know, give the peace sign. And if you look at it, when he realizes that he's going to die, his hands are like this, and then one of his hands goes like that. And she sees it, and that's why she starts crying even more, because that's him saying goodbye to her, knowing that he's not getting out of there alive, which I thought was like a nice like little nod or Easter egg or whatever you want to call it. But that was like the last season I paid attention to it. After that, it was just kind of like,
I'm trying to put myself through it, but it's torture, dude. As soon as they neutered Negan, I was like, motherfucker, now they made this guy a pansy.
Well, they're making a whole spin-off show with Negan now, like a whole they're making like a whole origin story with Negan.
Ugh. Oh no. I am so happy about that.
Wait, hold on, did I know something about movies and TV shows that you didn't?
I never knew about that shit, dude.
Holy fuck. 3 years in the making, but the moment has come.
I don't know.
I love Negan.
I can't get into Negan. I really can't get into Negan.
He is one of my favorite characters. That man, he is what society would become if that shit happened.
A douche with a bat and a harem?
No,
I mean, why not the harem?
No, but that's not what it was about. Come on. I mean,
you better repopulate, don't you?
He was a better leader than Rick ever was.
But I'm not into Walking Dead overall. I'm just really not. I can't get into that show.
I'm sorry. I was a fan of the governor. I was a fan of Negan.
I
think that they did the right shit. And then this fuckface, Rick, comes in and ruins everybody's shit and just completely obliterates this asshole. Like Negan says, this complete asshole destroys this peace that was created amongst them.
Well, there you go. Your review of Walking Dead.
Fuck yeah.
Did you guys watch Zombieland?
Huh. I love Zombieland.
Yeah.
I love Zombieland. I never watched Double Tap, but I did.
You haven't seen Double Tap yet?
I haven't. I heard really mixed reviews on it.
I mean, the first one's still better.
Yeah.
But the second one's actually not bad. Like, it's very much along the same lines. It's got like the same, like, it doesn't ever really slow down. It's funny. I mean, there's new characters and everything. There's a few plot holes, which I was like, okay, that was a waste of time. But I mean, like, if you get a chance to see it, watch it. Cause it's, if you enjoyed the first one, you'll enjoy the second one. Definitely.
Another movie that got ruined for me because I didn't realize she was the little girl from Definitely Maybe. The younger sister. She's the little daughter in Definitely Maybe. And I didn't realize that. And it ruined it for me.
Who?
The girl.
Well, what's the movie?
Well, Definitely Maybe was the movie she was in when she was the little girl. And he was explaining to her about his relationship with the three women. Do you remember that movie with Ryan Reynolds?
No.
Yeah. So she was in that and it was cute and
sweet.
Oh,
yeah.
They were like, well, you know, she's also the girl in Zombieland. I was like, fuck's sake.
Oh, shit. I didn't know that.
Like, why do you ruin that?
Oh, yeah. She's the little girl from Little Miss Sunshine.
Yeah.
Just, it ruined it for me. I was like, well.
Abigail Breslin.
Yeah. God, I hated Little Miss Sunshine. That movie was so stupid. That was as bad as Juno. It was so full of itself. It's like, oh, this is made for hipsters. Please enjoy this movie.
I didn't mind Juno. I wouldn't watch it again, but I didn't end the movie going, oh, this was a waste of my life. I was like, okay. I watched it because everyone was talking about it. I was like, all right, I want to be able to speak to it and know what I'm talking about. It's sort of like why I watched Walking Dead. Everyone was talking about it. I'm like, all right, if I'm going to, like, or I read part, oh, no, I watched the Twilight movies because I was like, all right, if I'm going to rant against it because I hated it on principle, I was like, let me watch it because at least I can speak to it and know exactly what I'm talking about. So, you know, I didn't hate Juno, though. I wouldn't watch it again, but...
Yeah, I mean, like, I didn't really buy the chemistry between Michael Cera and Elliot Page.
Oh, God.
They just seemed like they were cast, but you couldn't really feel like, you know, like, it was a good story, but there was just not that, like, even, like, accidental thing. It was just kind of like, eh, okay.
Best Michael Cera film, check out Nick and Nora's Playlist. I fucking love that movie.
I didn't like that movie. I tried to watch it, and I stopped it for, like, 20 minutes.
I love Scott Pilgrim versus the World. That's my jam when it comes to Michael Cera.
It's very similar to Nick and Nora's Playlist. I think you'll like that.
Okay.
It's not as stylized. It's not so, like, comic booky, but... But I think you'll enjoy it.
All right, wrapping it up, because this is starting to disintegrate into a Man Bites film episode right now.
All right, guys, so please tell us your stories about Valentine's Day, the good, the bad, all the weird shit that you encountered as well.
Especially the ugly.
Yes. Exactly.
The walk of shame.
Walk of shame.
Oh my God, we all have at least one of those in our back pockets, whether we want to admit it or not.
Yes. 100%. So yeah, please comment down below on the either the YouTube feed or on the Facebook page, whichever one, and let us know your stories, your crazy fucking shit that you encountered, because that's what we're here for. We want to listen to everybody's stories. Now you heard ours, we want to hear yours. So my name is Lewis.
My name's Naomi.
I am William.
And this is Lunattix, episode motherfucker 1.
I was here when it all began. All right.